Welcome to ExcelBerry. In this video, we will unlock the full potential of ChatGPT plus Excel. So you probably by now have created an account and tested to write some prompts. In this video, we will go through how you do that in the best possible way. And we will do this by solving a very common task in accounting, and that's when you have mismatch between the general ledger, the accounting, and the bank statement. So we have two sheets with dates and values from the bank and then from the accounting, and then we have a sheet with differences, and we want to highlight where we have differences between those two, either in the values or in the dates. So we will solve this using ChatGPT, and I'll show you what I wrote and what you should think of when you write your prompts. So let's dive right into it. So here is our prompt. We will go through it soon. First of all, you need to think before you do. So think of the end goal and how you would get there by yourself. In this case, I would probably go to the differences sheet and clear the filter that's already there. Then I would remove all the values that's already there. Then I would copy from the accounting and bank sheet into the differences sheet, add the sheet name, and then I would add the date and the value together and see how many duplicates we have. If there are more than one, then you have the date and value together two times, meaning that you probably have it in both the bank and the accounting sheet. So that's the steps that I would want to do. So what you do is that you write them down. Here's the step. So if there are filters in the sheet differences, please remove it. Then remove the cell values. Do not remove the format, copy and add from which sheet it was copied from. Add a concatenate of the A and B columns. That means the columns 3 and 4 to the left. Then you add a formula that counts how many times the value appears. You sort it and then you filter it to be equal 1. And then you have all the uniques and you have your errors. So think before you do. And be very specific with your prompt. Give the AI bot as little opportunity as possible to think by itself. So it's better to write more words than less words. Then we have provide a context. For example, create an optimized macro in VBA. So we use the word optimized, we use the word VBA, we use the word cell and be very specific with which cells, which sheet, which column, which row, and so on. So be very specific and provide context. Also provide and define the expected formats. For example, we write do not remove the format, paste it as values. So define the expected format, that's also good. And read through the answer. When ChatGPT provides you the answer, they will also give some clarification to what it wrote. And it's good to read this through before you just copy and paste it into your module. Also, you need to read through the macro, of course, and we will do that when we have it. This is perhaps the most important one to think of. ChatGPT is not a search engine. Think more of it as a person with very great knowledge. This means that you could have a conversation with the chatbot instead of just getting one answer and then go on to the next question. So tweak it, add, change, remove things. Also, if it did something wrong, because it will provide you wrong answers more than once, tell it did wrong. This line does not work. please change it. Or here, you didn't do what I expected you to do. Please change that. Some handy expressions are, for example, think step by step. So you let the AI bot think step by step, and that's usually how you want it. Also, you can write in the style of, and then insert a famous person, write a children's book in the style of Astrid Lindgren. You could also have the words act as a, and then insert a profession or a role. In this case, we will write act as an accountant working in Excel. What you do is that you set the room for the AI. The answers that you will get when the AI bot act as what you want it to act as will be better. This is the most common expression that I've seen on forums, and when I try it myself, it works out quite good. Let's try this one here. So we copy it, we go to ChatGPT, open a new chat, paste it here. Let's see what it writes. Another thing that's great for you to know is that I've given the chatbot the exact same prompt multiple times, and it will provide me different answers each time. So if the macro does not work, you could perhaps write the same prompt once again and see if the answer is different, and perhaps it works this time. Here we have our macro. We didn't get any information. So let's try it and read the macro through together. So we copy it, we go to Excel, go to our developer tab if you don't have it, right click on any of the tabs, customize the ribbon, and make sure that the developer tab is marked. Then you go to it, go to Visual Basic, that's where we will insert our macro, find our Excel workbook, find our modules, that's where you insert the macro, and then press on insert a module. This will be module 4 here, and paste it here. Let's go through it from the beginning to the end and see if it did what we wanted it to do. First, step 1. Sheets differences show all data. That means that you clear filters, but it didn't add an if statement. And I wanted to add an if statement because if the filters already cleared, we will get an error message and the macro will not proceed. So we go back to our ChatGPT and add for step 1, you did not add an if statement. Please do that and only that. So we don't want it to add the entire macro once again. Let's see what it does here. Yeah, it adds an if statement, and hopefully this works better this time. So we copy it here, go to our Visual Basic, and change this one here. Then we have step 2, so we clear our values. With sheet differences, clear content. That's what we wanted it to do. Then we wanted to copy and paste values. Let's see if this works. Then we add a formula that concatenate, then we add a formula to count, then we sort our data, and then we filter. Let's run it and see if it does what we want it to do or if it goes wrong. So let's go back to our Visual Basic and run the macro. Here we can see that it filtered values, but it did it with the A column. That's wrong, so we clear it. And we can also see that it didn't add the bank name to the sheets here. So somewhere here in the code, something went wrong. So here in this line, you can see that it filters on field 1, that's the first column. You could have a conversation with the AI and tell it you didn't filter on the E column, you filtered on the A column. Or if you know some macros, you would know that the A, B, C, D, E, the fifth column, let's change it to a 5 here. Let's try to run it again. You'll see that it now filters on the E column. Now we need to add the sheet name bank to these. We do that by having a conversation with the AI. It did not add bank to all cells. Please provide only that line again. Then it does exactly the same. So here, after trying it a couple of times, so hopefully this time it will work. So it added a range instead of just one cell. C plus the last row in the A column with C and the last row in the A column once again. But we want it to be in the C column here and then the A column here. Let's try it. And here we will see bank accounting. So this is probably correct. We used some knowledge of macro and also ChatGPT, but this looks wrong. So let's see the formulas. So this one is a concatenate of that and that. That's all right. This is count if. This takes a range and not the entire D column. Let's go to our macro and find it here. So here it says D2 to D and the number of cells. Let's change that. So we remove everything here, write DD and D2. So that's how you write the count if. So you have the entire D column is equal to what's in the D column. Then you count. And now it works exactly like we wanted it to work. So you have differences on the 8th of April between the accounting and bank, because in the accounting you only have 111, in the bank you have more than 100,000. And you can more easily go through this one here instead of trying to find the differences going back and forth between these two sheets. Maybe you have way too many lines to be able to do this, then this macro could help you to make it faster. And that's best practice when it comes to creating your prompt and how you work with ChatGPT together with Excel and, in this specific case, macros. And that's all I wanted to show you in this video. Please subscribe if you want to learn even more in Excel, AI, ChatGPT. DALL-E is coming up also. And like the video if you learned something, and go my Excel course on ExcelBerry.com. Thank you.